गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस साचे पोर्शन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री व्हिच इज वेरी वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर योर बोर्ड एग्जाम. नॉट ओनली दैट, इट इज रिक्वायर्ड इन केस ऑफ योर क्लास 11. ऑलवेज वन क्वेश्चन विल कम from 12th board exam, entrance exam also, when you will appear in JEE Main, NEET, AIIMS, there also one question should be there for naming. So it is one of the most important part of your organic chemistry. That is nomenclature, naming of organic compounds, naming of organic compounds. And you should be very, very serious and listen sincerely every point, because today we will discuss about the various rules by which you can give the IUPAC naming of any organic compound. At the very beginning, what is the requirement of this nomenclature? What is the requirement of this naming of organic compound? When we are inventing various number of compounds, organic compounds one after another, then it is very difficult to know them as per their common name, because the number of organic compounds millions, number of organic compounds in millions. For that we require some rules by which we can give the name, and if this rule follow all over world, then the name will be same. For that, various scientists of various countries will join with each other and will form a committee. The name of this committee is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, IUPAC. And here they set some rules, and all over world should follow that rule to give the name of an organic compound, to give the name of an organic compound. In case of our personal name, there we are following three part. If you see the computerized form, then you should see three parts are there in case of your name. One is our first name, second is our second name, and the last is our surname. First name, second name, surname. If we consider any name of you, Adit, Kumar, Srivastav, three parts are there. Like that, in case of our organic compounds also, three parts are there: root names, primary suffix, secondary suffix. But in case of this type of naming, when we will consider very small structural formula, then that will not be a problem. But as soon as we will consider a long chain, then we should follow some rules, and today we will discuss that rules by which we can understand what will be the name of that compound. So now our topic is naming of organic compound. Our topic is naming of organic compound. Naming of organic compound, and this is also known as IUPAC naming. This is also known as our IUPAC naming. We again repeat the full form of IUPAC, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. In case of our rules, the first rule is, if we consider any long chain, the first rule is we should number the carbon chain in such a way that the chain should be longest and continuous. The chain should be longest and continuous. We should number the chain in such a way that we can get the longest chain as well as continuous chain. If we consider any chain, if this chain will go like this, from here it is this, from here this, 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 like this way, this is our continuous chain. This is our continuous chain. We should not cross the line. We should not cross the line. That is our continuous. And the longest chain, it is clear, the maximum number of carbon we should take in that chain, then only the chain will be longest. So the first rule is, in case of long chain compound, in case of long chain compound, at first we should give the number of carbon such a way that the chain should be longest and continuous. This chain is known as parent chain It may be straight. It may be straight. It may be straight or may not be straight or may not be straight. So here what we are writing, in case of long chain compound, at first we should give the number of carbon in such a way that the chain should be longest and continuous. This chain is known as parent chain. It may be straight or may not be straight. It may not be straight. As for example, if we consider the carbon like this way, carbon, 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 carbon. And all of you know that in every carbon there should be four number of bond. If we consider this one, here one bond, two bond, three bond and four bond. Like this way, this carbon, four number of bond, this carbon, four number of bond, here also four number of bond, and here also four number of bond. If we number the chain like this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five number of carbons are there. For that, the parent chain will be, pentane. For that, the parent chain will be pentane. It is a straight chain. For that, numbering will not be difficult. But if we consider the chain like this, carbon, 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 like this. If we consider the chain like this. Here, if we take the straight chain, that is 1, 2, 3, only 3 number of carbon is present. If we take this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 number of carbon is present. But we should take care about the longest chain. If we give the number like this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here the chain is continuous, no doubt. Here the chain is continuous because the chain is like this, this one, this and this. So this line is continuous. So no problem. And here we are considering, or here we are getting 6 number of carbon. Maximum number of carbon we are getting by this numbering. Or we can take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, both are same. So by this way, we are getting the longest chain. So if we consider any chain, at first we should see, we should number in such a fashion that the chain should be longest and continuous. It may be straight, may not be straight. Am I clear? And the number of carbon which are present and the number of carbon which are present, that is our parent carbon. If one number of carbon is present, then methane. Two number of carbon is present, ethane. Three number of carbon is present, propane. Four number of carbon is present, butane. If they are only single bond present. If in between two carbon, double bond is present, then it will be in ethene, propene, butene, pentene. If in between two carbon triple bond is present, then it is iene, ethyene, propyne, butyne, pentyne, like this way. Now the first rule is clear to all of you. The first rule, in case of any long chain compound, we should take care about the number of carbon. We should give the number of carbon in such a way that the chain should be longest and continuous. It may be straight, may not be straight. We should take care about the number of carbon, and here the chain should be longest and continuous. Second point, in case of numbering, we should take care about the substituent. What is our substituent? The branch of this carbon chain. The branch of this carbon chain is known as our substituent. In this substituent, we may take any alkyl group such as methyl, ethyl, propyl, butyl. We may take any type of halogen, that is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. We may take any type of functional group such as hydroxyl, aldehyde group, ketone group, acid group. We can take that. There are various type of branch are there, which we known as our substituent. We always take care the chain should be longest and continuous, as well as lowest number should come in branch chain. Lowest number should come in branch chain. Now, the second point we should write. In case of our second point, the lowest number should come in branch chain. As for example, if we take a compound like this, carbon, 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 and here CH3. This CH3 is our methyl group. If one hydrogen of any alkane will come out, then the substance which will be rest, that is our alkyl. If we consider methane, then CH3 will be the methyl, because the formula of methane is CH4. If one hydrogen is come out, then it will produce the corresponding alkyl. Methyl, ethyl, propyl, butyl, like this. If we consider this one, we can give the number like this way: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can give the number like this way: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can give the number from right end also. Here we are considering from left end. We can give the number from right end also: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can give the number from right end also. But if we number if we number the carbon compound from left end in this compound, that will be right. But if we number from right end, that will be wrong. What is the cause behind it? Now, we already discussed lowest number should come in branch chain. If we give the number like this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then branch chain will come in second carbon. Then branch chain will come in second carbon. But if we give the numbering from right end, then 1, 2, 3, 4, fourth carbon, we are getting the branch chain. So here we already discussed lowest number should come in branch chain. In the previous one, we are getting in the second carbon. And if we give the number from right end, the branch will be in fourth carbon. For that, the first one is right. This is our right numbering. This is our wrong numbering. So always we should take care. Chain should be longest and continuous, no problem. But we should take care about the second point also. We should take care about the second point also, that the lowest number should come in branch chain. Lowest number should come in branch chain. But if there alkyl group as well as functional group present, if there alkyl group as well as functional group present, then first preference we will give to the functional group. Lowest number should come at the functional group first, after that alkyl group. If there both functional group and alkyl group present as the substituent, then first preference we should give to the functional group and second preference we will give to the alkyl group. If we consider any compound like this, carbon, 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 and here one methyl group present and here one hydroxyl group present. Hydroxyl group is our functional group. OH group is our functional group. CHO, that is aldehyde group, is one of the functional group. COOH, that is acidic group, is one of the functional group. And CO group is also one of the functional group. So if we consider this chain, then we can number it like this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 carbons we are getting. We can give the number like this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here what we see, in the first numbering, if we consider this one, second carbon hydroxyl present and fourth carbon methyl present. But if we consider this one, in second carbon methyl present and fourth carbon hydroxyl present, and we already discussed, if both of these CH3 and OH, alkyl and hydroxyl, alkyl and any functional group present, then functional group should give the first preference. As a result, the upper one numbering is right, whereas the lower one is wrong. Because in case of upper one, second carbon hydroxyl group present, fourth carbon alkyl group present. But in the second one, in the lower one, second carbon alkyl group present and fourth carbon hydroxyl group present. For that, the upper one will be right. So these we already discussed about the three rules, and in the next class we again discuss about the other rules by which you can give the name of organic compound easily, which is very, very important for your board exam. Not only board exam, in your entrance exam like JEE Main, JEE Main, JEE NEET, aims like this. For that, lifelong, if you are with chemistry, then lifelong this nomenclature will require. For that, this is very, very important. And as soon as you know the rules of naming and can give the name of the organic compound, then you can consider that 10% of organic chemistry is over. For that, be serious and be careful about this chapter, about this portion, which is very much required in your class 11, class 10, class 12 and entrance exam. Okay, beta. Thank you.